Joining us on the line, rather, is Philip Tourney. He's a Vietnam War veteran and the author of What I Saw That Day. Many thanks for joining us here on Press TV, sir. Now, this will be the largest and more significant joint exercise in the Allies' history, in which the notorious Iron Dome system will be tested as well. What do you make of this further militarization of Israel in what many call a very volatile region?
I think very, very little of it. I must say this. I am a USS Liberty survivor that was attacked on June 8, 1967, where 34 of my shipmates were slaughtered by the government of Israel in a premeditated attack. And they knew exactly who we were. They knew exactly where we were going. We were in international waters. And the government of the United States covered up this heinous attack that murdered 34 of my shipmates and wounded 174 others, including myself, and wounded our ship so badly it had over 850 cannon rocket holes in it, over 5,000 armor-piercing bullets in it. It had a 40 by 40-foot torpedo put in it. As the Israelis shot our only three life rafts out of the water, there were to be no survivors, and as they shot at our firefighters and stretcher bearers. And I must say this, ma'am. I am an American, and I love my country just as you love your country. It's my duty as an American to warn the world about the neocon Zionist threat that poses a great evil on this country, in all countries. And I must also add, AIPAC, which is a filter that puts out garbage against all countries. So the end in saying this is that Israel is no friend of America. No friend of America. If they can get by with murdering 34 Americans on the high seas, doing nothing but what our government orders do, and then the American government covers up for it, it's just like your father and your mother would shoot you in the back of the head, and then they would go get the people that shot you in the back of the head and get them out of jail. Does that sound fair to you, ma'am?
What do you make of this further militarization of Israel and what many call a volatile region?
What I make of it, it says U.S.-Israel plan, largest war games, and this is the largest war games between two allies that I've ever heard of. These aren't war games. This is real war. And I do not want to see any more deaths.
Yes.
We've already fought two wars for Israel. We're still fighting them for Israel, for Iraq and Iran. And it's despicable. We're losing American blood and treasure. This country's broke. We can't afford it anymore. Israel is living high. They have more money, more missiles. They have, if they say they have 200 nuclear weapons, they got 1,000 of them. I can guarantee it.
Right now, Israel is developing the Arrow 3 with the U.S. Department of Defense. Now, the Americans will be shouldering the bulk of the project's financing. Wouldn't this money be put to better use at this time of economic uncertainty, in your opinion?
Absolutely. This money could be used to pay off our national debt. This money could be used to bring our troops home from fighting these wars for Israel. This money could be used to put many uses, hospitals, schools, people that are out on the streets, foreign aid except for anybody for Israel. I think Israel does not need foreign aid. They got plenty of money. They got plenty of nuclear weapons, enough to destroy the world. And they said that over and over and over again. So, no, this could be used in so many different ways. The money does not have to be spent on Israel or their warning to Iran that they're going to wipe you off the earth.
All right, we're going to have to leave it there. That was Phil Tourney, Vietnam War veteran and the author of What I Saw That Day, joining us on the line from Grand Junction. Mr. Tourney, many thanks for your insights here on Press TV.